Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. we have the proud privilege of having with us Honorable Minister of State for Electronics and IT, Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Shri Rajiv Chandrasekhar ji. To begin with, I would like Mr. Ashwini Rana to present a bouquet to the Honorable Minister. Ashwini ji. I would now like to call upon Mr. Shivnath Tukral to present a shawl to the Honorable Minister. Thank you. I now call upon Mr. T.V. Ramachandran to kindly present a bouquet to Madam Aruna Sundarajan, our chairperson of BIF. I would then call upon, again, TV sir, to kindly present a bouquet to Professor Rekha Jain, professor, one of the co-authors of this report that we are releasing today. I'll also now once again call upon Mr. Shivnath Tukral to present a bouquet to Professor Pingali. With this out of the way, we'd like all the distinguished dignitaries on the dais to kindly stand up for a photo op, please. Thank you all. I now take the opportunity to invite our President, Mr. T.V. Ramachandran, to give the welcome address. As you all know, he's the president of BIF. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Debu. Good morning, all. Respected Minister of State, Sri Rajiv Chandrasekhar ji. Respected Professor Rekha Jain ji. Respected Professor Vishwanath Pingali ji. Madam Aruna Sundarajan, Chairperson of BIF, Vice President Ashwini Rana, Vice President Shivnath Tukral, distinguished guests, esteemed members of the government, industry, media, it gives me great pleasure to be with you all today for this important occasion from our point of view. We don't need to labor much on the importance of the digital economy for this country. I'm reminded of a favorite number of mine in my younger days, used to be called the Age of Aquarius by the Fifth Dimension. I would say this is the age of India, that is Bharat, and the age of the app-driven digital economy. The digital economy is nothing without apps, and we all saw that during COVID. During COVID, so useful telecom was, but it would have been of very little purpose if we didn't have the content of the apps which drove it. It was the apps which had gave your entertainment, gave you the ability to conference, to work still, to continue education from home. So the apps have been driving that economy at that time, ensured that we could progress, and we became the envy of many countries in the world. And that continues even today. Apps are really growing and growing every day here in India. You go to rural areas, video constitutes 70% of the traffic. Data-driven traffic, and as you can understand it, the aam aadmi in the rural and semi-urban areas, he would prefer to see through video, learn through video, rather than written mail. He may not be so literate. So we have to nourish, cherish and grow the app economy. We do know that and understand that, all of us. And it is not just for entertainment, it is for the socio-economic growth of this country, of this great nation. We should, for example, be proud of the fact that in the current regime, thanks to all the support we are having from government in the last few years, India leads in terms of the number of app downloads in the world. Okay, the largest downloads of 29 billion in 2022, as per App Annie, and that, I would say, the highest in any democratic country. China is above us, but then we are highest. Even USA is far behind us. So we need to grow this for the benefit of the Aam Aadmi. BIF, Broadband India Forum, which is a think tank for digital transformation, believes strongly in the importance of app economy, and we have been working on this, researching in this area since 2017. And so we are very proud to be releasing a report by three distinguished professors of IIM Ahmedabad on the economic value of the app economy today. I will not continue to take your time more because the minister does not have, with his hectic schedule, he doesn't have too much time. I would like to now let Professor Rekha Jain, one of the co-authors, walk you around the key highlights of this report. Professor Rekha Jain needs no introduction. I made a mistake. I would first like to invite Chairperson Aruna Sundarajan, Madam, to come and give her welcome address. I'm sorry for the lapse.
Honorable Minister of State for Electronics and IT, Sri Rajiv Chandrasekhar, dignitaries on the dais, including the authors of the study report that's going to be released by the minister shortly, Mr. Ramachandran, who has been the moving force behind BIF, a very good morning to all of you. As you know, over the last few years, BIF has been endeavoring to play the role of a think tank and to present to the Indian government studies, research reports, etc., that can help in crafting appropriate regulation and regulation and an enabling environment. Mr. Ramachandran has already mentioned about the runaway growth of the app economy in India. App Annie has estimated that India is probably the highest consumer of apps. We all consume apps, so we don't really need to dwell on that. I just want to make a few short points. One is that we all know the background in which the Indian government has been looking at the whole digital economy, a 1 trillion digital economy in a larger 5 trillion Indian economy. In 2020, already the core digital sector was estimated to be around 7 to 8%. It's probably even larger now. India's export of ICT was earlier basically only software, but now under the highly proactive initiatives of the government, India is now, you know, coming up as an exporter of hardware. We know that as we go forward and smartphone penetration expected to reach, you know, almost 1 billion in the next few years, the app economy's importance is only going to grow larger. And so as India looks to craft regulation, overall digital regulation, but also looking at the app economy, we do recognize that even the app economy needs some kind of regulation, but it needs to be soft touch regulation, And we hope that this study research that's going to be presented today will provide pointers and insights to the Indian government as to what is the contribution of the app economy, what does the ecosystem look like, what is it going to look like, what will be the key drivers and enablers, and how do we ensure that government continues to enable the growth and rise of the app economy. I know that all of you are keen to hear the authors of the report. We are even keener to hear the minister. And so I would just like to thank the minister for taking time off for releasing this very important study. I'm grateful to all of you for being here today to share this very important occasion with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Aruna Sundararajan. As you all know, our distinguished chairperson was one of the ones who inspired us to set up Broadband India Forum as a think tank way back in 2015. So thank you, madam, for all your inspiration. I have now great pleasure in inviting Professor Rekha Jain, who is a visiting professor of ICRIA, past professor of IIMA, and head of the Telecom Center of Excellence there, to come and present the highlights of her of their report. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you all for being present, and I'd like to thank the minister, the honorable minister, and the BIF for giving us this opportunity to do this study and share our results with all of you. So, I'm very aware of the points that have been made and the time constraints, so I'm just going to focus on very few slides that are there. The slide as such will be available on the website for greater details. In the recent visit of the Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji to the USA, one thing that stood out was he was very visibly proud of the digital developments that have happened in India, and he mentioned that 40% of all digital transactions that happen globally are from India. I think this is a very great and important number. And therefore, that should be the focus on why or how this economy, the digital economy, is contributing to the Indian economy as such. So let's proceed forward. What we mean by the app economies are all the economic activities which involve the development of apps, sale of apps, in-app purchases, subscriptions, advertisements, and the economic opportunities arising to those who are public relations generated by free apps. And this is only the direct contribution. Our study does not look at the indirect and the tertiary contributions, because we wanted our nobody to question the results, to make it a robust study, because data on the indirect and induced effect is still not very solid and is not very robust. And so we all know about the app economy ecosystem. We are all aware of the role of content providers, app stores, advertisers, app developers, and smartphone manufacturers, ICT network providers in this app economy. Aruna ji just mentioned about the previous slide, so I'm not spending time on that. And we all know what this digital economy is driven by, and one interesting result we found out was 69% of last 4 year IPOs operate in the digital domain, and the 20% of digital and unicorn are emerging from this digital ecosystem. So what was the outcome directly to our study? What was the methodology we used? We used a very simple and robust methodology for us. That was important. We looked at the GDP growth of India until 2030. Our results are valid until 2030. From 2020 to 2030, we did this. And we looked at what was the rate of growth of GDP. We looked at the number of smartphone users and how they're likely to increase over this period, the amount spent on apps per hour, and we looked at the number of hours per day that any user would spend. Now, these For 2022, we had exact data. We have projected it onto 2030. Now, when we looked at these projections, we have taken into account that the digital economy grows at 2.5 times the rate of growth of the physical economy. Now, what were our results? What was interesting was that by 2030, the amount of money spent on apps is likely to be around US$880 billion. And this is only the direct effect. If we take into account the indirect and induced effects, which I referred to, is going to be far greater, because in the digital economy, we know the indirect and induced effects are often 2.5, 3 times, 4 times larger. The Indian economy at that time is expected to be $6.6 trillion, and therefore we can say that the app economy would contribute to 12% of our GDP on a very, very conservative estimate. And what is interesting is when we look at the growth rate of the app economy, it is computed as 32% growth rate, which is 4 times the growth rate of the GDP, the physical GDP. So these are very important, pointers. We wanted to compare what is the rate of growth of the app economy in India versus that in the UK and US. Now, getting such data is very difficult, but we did get it for UK and EU, not US. UK and EU. In the EU and UK, the rate of that percentage, what I said was 12% in 2030. And is 2% in 2021 for India, was 0.75 and 1.5% for EU and UK respectively. So we can see that this contribution on an apple-to-apple basis is far greater for India than for these developed countries, where we may expect these effects should be higher. And we believe that this is because of the larger role of digital payments in India. If we look at digital payments in India versus those in the UK, we have already reached $1.5 trillion worth of digital payments in 2022, and whereas in UK that was around $440 billion. So you can see the kind of difference, and these are obviously clear pointers to the government as to which directions. One is strengthening the UPI digital infrastructure. Government apps can play a very important role in strengthening and taking forward this thing. The PLI scheme, whatever is required for the ICT network infrastructure. And our study is framed around the app economy being the attention economy, and therefore we look at hours spent, we look at what exactly a consumer or a citizen does on the apps. So thank you very much. That's the end of my talk.
Thank you, Professor, for presenting the highlights of that paper by you and your two co-authors, Professor Vishwanath Pangli, who is taken time out to come here from Ahmedabad, and Professor Ankur Sinha of IIM Ahmedabad again, all three of them. A remarkable report, and Madam, as you highlighted, it's a humongous number, contribution of 12% to the GDP, and growth rate, which is 4 times the growth rate of the economy. So powerful results you have given us. We're very happy to note that, and with this, I thank the professors and cordially invite respected Minister Shri Rajiv Chandrasekhar ji to release the paper and then give us that.
Thank you. I'd like to mention, ladies and gentlemen, that in consonance with the digital economy and the digital transformation that BIF stands for, we shall be providing you on your each of your tables a QR code by which you can download the entire report which has just been released by Honorable Minister, so so that you can take note of it. Thank you. With this, I would now request TV sir to take over.
Thank you, Debu. I have great pleasure now to say a few words about our respected minister before inviting him to come and deliver his address. He, of course, needs no introduction. He's a fantastic person, and I have had the privilege of reporting directly to him for 3 years, sir. And I know one thing. He's a workaholic to the real quintessence. And right from morning till night, he'll be driving targets, work, achievements. So on the breakfast table in the morning, I was sure to get a call from sir asking, what did you complete that yesterday? And so that's the way it went. It is really fortunate that he could spare a few minutes from his undoubtedly hectic schedule to be with us today to release the paper. I request him now to deliver his address. Over to you, sir.
Srimati Aruna Sundarajanji, Professor Rekha Jain, a blast from the past, T.V. Ramachandran, Shivnath Tukral, Professor Pingali, and ladies and gentlemen, thank you for inviting me here to speak on the occasion of this release of this report on the research paper on the economic value of the app economy in India. Certainly, it's something that all of us intuitively recognize is a very important part of the digital economy, the app economy. It is good, therefore, to have a document that lays out the quantitative and the qualitative basis of its impact on the overall digital economy. So thank you for the work, BIF. Thank you, Professor Jain and your colleagues. I'm running a little behind schedule, so I won't make it too long. I won't certainly bore you on a Friday just before the weekend with a longish speech, but I will certainly make some points that I hope will be of interest to you. Anybody who's today a participant, spectator, policymaker, observer of the India's digital economy will certainly come to this reasonably simple conclusion that we are living in very exciting times. The digital economy today is one of the most exciting digital economies anywhere in the world. And what we are seeing in terms of growth, both in terms of the depth and the breadth of that growth in the digital economy, is something that is unprecedented. For those of us who have been in tech for over 3 decades, this is certainly the most exciting time to ever be in the tech space. Along with the energy and the overall momentum in the Indian ecosystem, you are also seeing these big, decisive strategic relationships forming globally. The India-US relationship on critical and emerging technologies that our Honorable Prime Minister was in the US for, the India-EU Technology and Trade Council relationship. These are also signaling in many ways that India is going to be amongst the leading pack of nations and the leaders, leading countries, and Indian entrepreneurs, Indian startups, and Indian innovation will certainly be playing a very decisive role in the shaping and the future of technology in general. There was a reference made to the digital economy, and I certainly want to share with you the contours around which our Prime Minister has laid out the policies and the frameworks and the outcomes that are expected, the targets that have been set for the digital economy. And I'll start certainly with the single biggest number, that we expect the digital economy to be $1 trillion by 2026. So that is one number. The second most important number or a descriptor of that number is that it is going to take us to a place where the digital economy is going to be 20% of the overall GDP. And to put it in perspective, in 2014, tech and digital economy constituted about 4-4.5% of GDP. So A, we are growing faster than the GDP. B, the composition and the nature and the character of our GDP is going to be increasingly digital and technology led. Now, what is the digital economy? And therefore, again, I take you back to 2014, when any conversation about India and tech and India and Indian digital economy was held, we essentially referred to those IT and ITES companies and the great work that they were doing, creating employment, creating jobs, the progress that they had made from the Y2K to where they were in 2014. But in large part, we were very unidimensional in terms of our digital economy. And post 2014, if you take a look back from 2023 to where we are, if you do a report card, you will find that there is no space now in the technology ecosystem or the technology space that India is not present in, or Indian startups are not present in, or Indian enterprises and young Indians are not present in. So whether it's electronics manufacturing or design, semiconductor manufacturing or design, the blockchain, the future of the internet and Web3, AI, high performance computing, quantum computing, IT, ITES, internet, consumer internet, every part of the digital space has now an Indian flag planted pretty deeply and pretty strongly, indicating that we are a much more diverse, much more expanded digital economy, and with participants in every aspect of it. I wanted to leave that thought before I just briefly dwell on the app economy and why it is so important and what is happening around that. As Professor Jain mentioned, between 14 and now, in the last 9 years, in the handset and smartphone ecosystem, we have gone from being a net importer and consumer of foreign-made products to now being a significant presence in the global value chains for electronics. Last year alone, we exported 1 lakh crores of Samsung and Apple phones, compared to 9 years ago, where we were importing 82% of our phones. Last year, we manufactured near 100% of all mobile phones consumed in India. And it is very natural from that we would then look at the soft parts of these smartphones, what powers these smartphones, what makes these devices so powerful, so important in consumers' lives. And so there we come straight to the app economy. There are two dynamics here on the app economy. Of course, there is the issue of the duopoly, the Google Play Store versus the Apple Play Store. There is that dynamic. But what is certainly catalyzing and triggering the growth of apps and will continue to trigger that is the rapid digitization of our economy in terms of services, products, and offerings to our citizens. Two data points that are certainly important for and will catalyze the app economy is, number one, the growth of internet penetration and access. India is today 83 crore Indians on the internet. By 2025-26, it will be 120 crore Indians. We are certainly the largest connected democracy in the world today. And by 26, we will certainly be the largest single collection of internet users on the global internet. So that is one trend. The second is that the government, as you have seen with the UPI, as you have seen with different apps that came in very handy, the DPIs during COVID, is accelerating the digitization of public services. So you have a use case of a government when the Prime Minister with his vision said, I want to ensure DBT, I want to ensure JDY, I want to ensure payments reach our citizens without leakage and without any corruption, created this architecture of digital payments, and lo and behold, you have UPI, and lo and behold, you have one of the fastest growing fintech ecosystems in the world with a proliferation of apps and proliferation of products and services being delivered to those apps. So central to this app economy and central to the development and expansion of the app is the government and its policies and our Prime Minister's vision that increasingly more and more public services should be digitized, more and more of the government should be digitized, and there should be more and more DPIs, digital public infrastructure, which is also part of the agenda of the G20, and more expansion and growth and innovation around the India stack. This phenomenon or phenomena of the government accelerating its digitization, enabling more and more platforms to develop and more apps to integrate and work off of those platforms, including but not limited to Aadhaar, UPI, Cowin, and multiple other things like skilling, education, will certainly be a force multiplier for the expansion of the app economy. The numbers that Professor Jain mentioned, that the global app, the value of the app economy is close to $1 trillion. For the last decade, a large number of that was driven by the US, North America, Europe, and in some parts from China. And I think in the coming decade, the India decade, we expect we will work together with the startups and youth and the entrepreneurship ecosystem to make sure that the Indian footprint or India-centric footprint or India-origin footprint in the global app economy becomes significant and grows rapidly. Professor Jain certainly makes a very strong point that the market is a significant market. India must increase its share in the app economy. I have made the point that the government is doing a lot by way of policies and enabling environment to allow more and more startups to be participants in the app economy. And we are certainly going to make sure that the Play Stores and the platforms that enable apps to reach consumers are much more open, transparent, accountable to the consumers and the enterprises and startups that depend on them. I will leave it at that. Again, I thank BIF, I thank TV and the team, and Arunaji and me go back some years where we've been on opposite sides sometimes and we've been on the same side many times. And so it's good to be on the same side on this very important occasion. And thank you, Professor Jain, for your work and your research. Thank you all for being here and for a patient listen. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister, for that excellent talk. I have now, as we come to the close of today's, end of today's function of the release of this excellent report on the economic value of the app economy, I have the distinguished honor to propose a vote of thanks to each and every one of you for gracing us with your presence. I'd first of all start by thanking our Honorable Chief Guest, Shri Rajiv Chandrasekhar Ji, Honorable Minister of State for Electronics and IT and Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, for taking out valuable time from his busy schedule to be here with us today and give us his valued guidance on the growth of the sector and the role of the government and how the whole ecosystem is going to prosper as a result of the combined efforts of the economic, of the government, industry, the academia, and all stakeholders. I'd also like to take this opportunity to extend our sincere thanks to the three professors from IMA, Professor Rekha Jain, Senior Visiting Professor Ikria and Professor IMA, retired Professor Vishwanath Pingali, Associate Professor, Co-Chairperson, Center for Data Science and Artificial Intelligence at IMA, and Professor Ankush Sinha, who could not be with us, for their hard work, dedication, and countless hours of research, which has resulted in preparation of this excellent and comprehensive analysis of the app economy. Your commitment, all of you, to excellence is truly commendable. Thank you. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank our chairperson, Madam Aruna Sundarajan, for taking time out and being here with us and giving us her valued suggestions on how to take the app economy forward. Our special thanks to Bharat Exhibitions, our event partner, who have gone above and beyond their remit to ensure the smooth execution of this event. Thank you very much, Shashiji. We also wish to thank Communications Today as our exclusive media partner, and also thank the entire BIF Directorate led by our President, Sri T.V. Ramachandran, for their contribution in making this event successful. Lastly, I would like to express our gratitude to each and every person in the audience here today for coming here after taking time out to have this report released and making this report release function more meaningful and inspiring. Your interest and enthusiasm in understanding the app economy highlights its significance and potential for the future. Thank you once again to each and every one of you. We look forward to future collaboration and continued success. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Before we sign off, I'd like to invite each and every one of you to the lunch, which is going to be served in the adjacent room. Thank you. Thank you, sir.